lower your numbers are as far as positive response goes, the more you probably want to think about personalization to increase those numbers. Although personalization doesn't always increase numbers. In fact, it can sometimes not increase anything at all or even decrease, because it might come across as like creepy or disingenuine, depending on what the information you're saying is, how you're saying it, and the context. So let me give you an example. If I say, like, I saw on LinkedIn that you do title X at company Y, that doesn't actually show me anything other than you were stalking me on LinkedIn and you probably want to sell me something. So that's not that useful. If you see that one of my skills is some specific software or tool on LinkedIn, just saying that on its own might not be helpful. But if you know that I have Salesforce, let's say, as one of my skills, and then you know that all the people that have the same title as me or like me have a specific complaint about Salesforce, and whatever you're selling solves that problem or makes it a lot easier, better, faster, cheaper, whatever. Now, if we know that, then we can bring up that information, and we're not even referencing necessarily the actual specific piece of information, but leveraging it to be relevant to that person's pain point or need in a way that it is personal, but we don't necessarily have to spell everything out. We don't have to say, oh, I was looking on LinkedIn or Crunchbase or whatever, and I saw. A lot of times it's actually better if you can infer information. But if you're trying to say, hey, I read your blog post on whatever, loved blah, 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 that might be good, but it's not necessarily always necessary. So as far as determining how much personalization or what personalization to use, usually what I recommend is kind of going with what I consider to be the bare minimum, which would be thinking about a specific buyer persona. So ideally like title, maybe industry, maybe company size, something like that. Having specific criteria, having first name, having company name, writing targeted relevant emails that focus on pain points and priorities you know they care about. Once you've done that, then you use those numbers as your baseline. So you say, okay, I have a 50% open rate on my emails and I'm getting a total of 18% positive response for my campaign. Good, but I want to do better. How can I do better? Let's see if I can do better. So that's where you take the same campaign and then maybe you see, okay, well, if in this email I test maybe adding their competitor name or the name of their product plus a compliment, or whatever's relevant in the case of what you're selling and that person's needs. If you take that and then you look and see, okay, compared to the email with zero or very, very minimal personalization, and then compared to this other email that has whatever personalization I'm testing, how much lift do I get? And sometimes, you know, you'll get a lot. Sometimes very little, sometimes none, sometimes negative. And then you just need to take those results and then see, okay, like, is it enough? Because you also have to factor how long it's taking you. So if you're getting like 1% more response, but it's taking you an hour for each one, probably not worth it unless you're selling really, really big things in a very small market.